Thank you. So thank you very much for the invitation. So this embedded contact homology is a version of flare homology defined for contact three manifolds. And so I'd like to explain an application of this theory to the study of three-dimensional wave flows. But by the way, is it working? Okay. Okay. Yeah. So yeah. So first, let me introduce some notation. So let a lambda be a contact manifold. So this y is an oriented 2n+1. Manifold, and lambda is a one harmonic such that lambda which d lambda to n is positive at every point. And so we can define the Reeb vector field r lambda to be the vector field on y defined by these two equations. And so we are interested in the set of periodic Reeb orbits, which we denote by Py lambda. So this is the, so it consists of gamma, that is a map from R over T gamma Z to Y. And so T gamma is a positive real number, and gamma is a integral curve of R lambda. And we also denote UY lambda. And so this is the union of images of all periodic Reeb orbits. So this is a subset of Y. And so for the most argument, we fix this manifold y and denote them just by p lambda or u lambda if there is no risk of confusions. So and so now we can state the main result of this talk. So let y lambda be a closed contact three manifold. So this is closed and three-dimensional. And let h be a C infinity function from y to the set of non-negative real numbers, and which is not constant to zero. Then there exists t in the 0-1 interval such that u of 1 plus th times lambda intersects the support of h. So in other words, there exists a periodic Reeb orbit of this perturbed contact form, which intersects the support of h. And so this is the main result. And it implies the following two corollaries. The first corollary is the so-called C infinity closing lemma. And so the statement is as follows. So let u be any non-empty open set in X. Then there exists a sequence fj. And so each fj is a C infinity function from y to the set of positive real numbers. And so for every j, u of fj times lambda intersects u. So there exists a periodic orbit of this contact form intersecting this open set. And this function fj converges to the constant function 1 in C infinity double G. And so the proof is almost immediate. So we just take such function h, which is supported on u. And by this result, we have a sequence tj. We have a sequence tj in the 0, 1 interval, which satisfies this condition. And it converges to 0. And so if we take fj to be 1 plus tj times h, it satisfies these conditions. And so in general, closing lemma considers the following question. So suppose we have a vector field defined on a manifold. And let P be a so-called non-wandering point. That means that for any neighborhood of P, there exists a trajectory of this vector field, which is not contained in this neighborhood, but its starting point and its ending point is in this neighborhood. So of course, it may not be a genuine periodic orbit. But we can ask if we can perturb this vector field to get a genuine periodic orbit intersecting this neighborhood. And the positive answer to this question is called the closing lemma. And so we can ask this question for various classes of dynamical systems. And we prove it for three-dimensional wave flows. And so this C infinity stands for the fact that this perturbation can be arbitrarily small in the C infinity topology. And the reason that it's called a lemma is that, so the reason that it's called lemma is that it implies the so-called C infinity general density theorem. Which states that for generic element f in the space of C infinity functions from y to the set of positive real numbers equipped with the C infinity topology, u of f lambda is dense in y. And so it is not difficult to prove it from the closing lemma. And and one can easily find the proof in the dynamics literature. So please let me skip this proof. And anyway, the significance of these results is that we consider C infinity topology on the space of contact forms. And indeed, the C2 version of these results followed from this classical result by Pugh and Robinson. In 80s. And so they proved the following thing. So let X omega be a symplectic manifold of arbitrary dimension, and H be a proper C2 function on X, and U be a non-empty open set in X. Then there exists a sequence Hj, and each Hj is a proper C2 function. And so the sequence Hj converges to H in the C2 topology. And for every J, U of Hj, so this is the union of periodic orbits of this Hamiltonian vector field intersects this open set. So this is a closing lemma for Hamiltonian vector fields, and so this is called a Hamiltonian C1 closing lemma, because they consider C1 perturbation of Hamiltonian vector fields, which corresponds to C2 perturbation of Hamiltonians. But anyway, so so it implies that when lambda is any contact manifold, closed contact manifold of arbitrary dimension, then for generic element f in the C2 functions on Y with C2 topology, U of F lambda is dense in Y. So we can just apply this result for the symplectization of this contact manifold. And so this is the C2 general density theorem for Reeb flows. However, the C infinity version of this result is known to be false. Indeed, there is a also well-known result by Hermann, who proved the following result. So let us consider two n-dimensional torus. And consider the Hamiltonian H naught defined by this formula. And what he proved is that when n is at least 2, there exists a symplectic form omega on the 2n-dimensional torus, such that when a Hamiltonian H is sufficiently close to H naught in the C infinity topology, then U of H, so this is the union of periodic orbits, is disjoint from this region. So one cannot get a periodic orbit in this region by C infinity small perturbation of this Hamiltonian. So this is a counter example to the C infinity version of this pure Robinson result. And in particular, when n is equal to 2, each level surface is 3-dimensional. On the other hand, what we have proved, it's C infinity general density theorem for three-dimensional Reeb dynamics. So that result cannot be generalized to this autonomous Hamiltonians. And we really need to use that contact assumption to prove it. And indeed, the proof uses a machinery from contact geometry that is embedded. Yes. So, yeah. So we put so this omega when n is 2. So we have this standard symplectic plus some maybe on. Linear terms, and the point is that we take this vector 1mb to satisfy the Diophantine condition, and then we can apply the Kamm theory. Sorry? Yeah. Yes. Yes. So yes. So if this vector satisfies the Diophantine condition, this vector field on each level surface is conjugate to this one. Yes. And yeah. So we need to use that. So now I want to explain the proof of the result. And so. Sorry.
So here you're somehow putting a closing numbers for vector fields, right?
Yes. And of course we can also discuss it for diffeomorphisms.
Right.
Actually, later we prove it for simple. So we prove it for Hamiltonian diffeomorphism on the on surface.
Right, but for the pure closing lemma,
yes.
I mean, it's not just true. Oh, I see. Never mind. Okay.
Yeah. So this pure. So pure. Yeah. Actually, pure Robinson proved a similar result for Hamiltonian diffeomorph. No. Symplectic diffeomorphisms. And so anyway, so we have to use that contact assumption to prove it. And so we use the theory of ECH. And so it was introduced by Hutchings. And the foundation had been developed in series of papers by Hutchings and Talbis. And so this is a flare homology for contact three manifolds. So we consider solid by lambda via closed contact three manifold. And we also assume that lambda is non-degenerate. That means that every periodic Reeb orbit, including multiple ones, one is not an eigenvalue of the linearized return map. And let the gamma be a one-dimensional homology class with the Z coefficient, and L be a positive real number. And given such data, one can define a Z2 module, ECH L of Y lambda gamma. And this is a homology group of the following chain complex. So the generator is so the generator is a finite set of periodic Reeb orbits. So more accurately, so we consider such finite set consists of such pairs, and each MI is a positive integer, and each gamma I is a simple periodic Reeb orbit, and we forget parameterization, and we require a condition that this sum of their homology classes is equal to gamma, and this sum of their periods is less than L, and also we assume that MI is equal to 1 when gamma I is hyperbolic. And so this is the definition of a generator. And this boundary operator is defined by counting J holomorphic currents in the symplectization with ECH index. Is equal to 1. And it was proved that if a J holomorphic current has ECH index 1, it is represented by this is a disjoint union of trivial cylinders and embedded holomorphic curves. And so this is the reason why this invariant is called embedded contact homology. So anyway, this is a very short description of this invariant. And So it depends on how to count the multiple covers, and so this current means that so we only consider we do not care about the branch point. And so for each real number L, we have this zeta module. And when L is less than L prime, there is a natural map from ECHL to ECH L prime. And we can take a direct limit as L goes to infinity. And it turns out it depends only on the contact distribution, which we denote by xi lambda. So this is, of course, kernel lambda. And the orientation is specified so that the lambda is positive. And and for each L, there exists an obvious map from ECHL of lambda to this limit, which we denote by I L lambda. And by using this map, we can define a so-called spectral invariant. It was also introduced by Hutchings in his paper, Quantitative ECH. And so let us consider ECH of y xi gamma. So xi is a contact distribution. And take a non-zero element sigma. And take non-degenerate contact form lambda so that xi lambda is equal to xi. And for each such lambda, we can define a spectral invariant C sigma of Y lambda, or C sigma of lambda, to be the infimum of L such that sigma is in the image of I lambda L. So this is a certain non-negative real number. And so this is a So this is a quantitative invariant of contact forms. So perhaps I should write it again. And it satisfies the following properties. The first property is so-called C0 continuity. That means that when f is a function from y to this interval, then C sigma of f lambda is between 1 minus epsilon times C sigma of lambda and 1 plus epsilon times C sigma of lambda. And by using this inequality, we can define this spectral invariant even when lambda is degenerate. So when lambda is degenerate, take our sequence Fj such that each Fj lambda is non-degenerate, and it converges to the constant function 1 in the C0 topology. And then we can define C sigma of lambda to be the limit of C sigma of Fj lambda. So so this limit exists by this inequality. And it still holds even when lambda or F lambda are degenerate. And the second condition, second property is so-called spectrality, which states that C sigma lambda is a finite sum of periods of periodic Rebovitz. And this is quite straightforward from this definition. And we denote this right-hand side by A plus Y lambda. And here, A stands for the action. And I put the plus here because we consider all these finite sums. And it's not difficult to show that this is a null set. That means that the Lebesgue measure of this set is equal to 0. And the proof is an easy application of Sartre's theorem. So details omitted. And now the next property, next property says that these spectral invariants recover the volume of a contact manifold, and this is a surprising result due to Cristofaro Gartner Hutchings and Ramos. And so first, let me explain assumptions. So first, we assume that this manifold Y is connected. And the next assumption is that C1 of C, so this is the first chunk loss, plus two times Poincaré dual of gamma, so this is an element of H2 of YZ, is a torsion element. And this first chunk loss is divisible by 2. So we can always choose gamma so that this is equal to 0. In particular, this is a torsion element. And this assumption implies that this ECH has relative Z grading. This is quite straightforward from the definition of ECH index. And it is known that this Z grading is always unbounded from above. And this is quite a deep fact. And the proof uses tau-based isomorphism between ECH and ECH and the Zyberg within Fourier cohomology. And finally, we consider sequence sigma k. So this is a sequence of non-zero homogeneous elements in ECH such that the grading goes to infinity. And there exists such sequence because this grading is unbounded from above. And so under these assumptions, they proved that the ratio of this grading and the square of this spectral invariant converges to the volume of a contact manifold. So here we have only relative grading. So this denominator has an ambiguity up to shift. However, it goes to infinity. So this limit of this ratio does not depend on that ambiguity. And anyway, so this is a surprising result because this each spectral invariant is just a finite sum of periods. And by considering the asymptotic of these invariants, we recover the volume of a contact manifold. So this is a global invariant of the contact forms. And so it immediately implies what I call local sensitivity. Which means that, so for any H, so that is a function from Y to the non-negative real numbers, and that is not constant to zero, there exists sigma such that C sigma of 1 plus H lambda is strictly larger than the C sigma of lambda. And this is because the volume of this contact form is strictly larger than the volume of this contact form. So when k is sufficiently large, sigma k should satisfy this strict inequality. And of course, this local sensitivity is much weaker than this volume property. But this is still strong enough to prove our main result. So let us recall the statement of the main result. So that, yes, yes, for, yeah, yes, yes, yeah, but so we take H so that, which takes non-negative real value. and not constant to zero. Actually, there are infinitely many classes because for every sufficiently large k, sigma k satisfies this inequality. But so is the statement clear? Okay, and it also follows from this volume property, because when the volume of this limit. And so the. So let us record a statement of the main result. So while lambda is a closed contact three manifold, and for any h that is a map from function from y to the set of non-negative real numbers and not constant to zero, there exists a t in the 0-1 interval such that the u of 1 plus th times lambda intersects the support of h. And so let us denote this contact form by lambda t. And so suppose that this is not the case. So that means that for any t in the 0-1 interval, u of lambda t is disjoint from the support of h. And so this u denotes the union of all periodic wave orbits. And so notice that lambda t is equal to lambda on the complement of support h. That is obvious from this formula. And so this is an open set. So their Reeb vector fields coincide. And our assumption is that every periodic orbit of this vector field is disjoint from support h. So p of lambda t, so this is the set of periodic orbits, is independent on t. And also a plus, which consists of all finite sum of periods, is independent on t. So for any t. And now, so let's see, be the kernel of lambda t. And this is also independent on t. And consider the ECH YXC gamma. And here gamma is arbitrary one-dimensional homology class. And take non-zero element sigma. And so let us consider the spectral invariant C sigma of lambda t. And then, so by the spectrality, this is an element of A plus of lambda t. And under our assumption, this is independent on t. And as I said, this is an offset. On the other hand, this C sigma of lambda t, this is a continuous function of t by the C0 continuity of the spectral invariant, and which takes a value in an L set. So it has to be a constant function. So in particular, C sigma of lambda is equal to C sigma of 1 plus H lambda for every non-zero element sigma in the ACH. And it clearly contradicts local sensitivity. So this is a very simple argument, which just combines a few properties of this spectral invariant. And now let me discuss two applications of this mean result. So the first application is about closed geodesics. So let QG be a closed Riemannian two-manifold, and U be a non-empty open set in Q. Then there exists F and gamma, and F is a C infinity function from Q to the set of positive real numbers, which is arbitrarily close to the constant function 1 in the C infinity topology, and the gamma is a non-constant closed geodesic on Q with symmetric F times G, such that gamma 0 is in this open set U. So by C infinity small perturbation of the Riemannian metric, we can get the closed geodesic, which passes through this open set. And the proof is, so this is really an immediate application. So we can just apply the closing lemma for three-dimensional Reeb flows to the Sophia cotangent bundle. And so this is a partial answer to the closing problem for the geodesic flows. And for the geodesic flow, the difficulty is that, this is a Q, and this is a point Q. And if we perturb a Riemannian metric on the neighborhood of Q, so this geodesic flow changes on this neighborhood of this whole tangent, whole cotangent fiber. So this perturbation can be never localized in the entire space of the cotangent bundle. And this is a serious difficulty to apply the Pugh Robinson argument. And as far as I know, even the C2 version of this result is new since this problem was first discussed in the Pugh Robinson paper. On the other hand, for C1 perturbation, there is this result by Refold, who proved that when QG is a closed Riemannian manifold of arbitrary dimension, so there exists F, which is arbitrary close to the constant function 1 in the C1 topology, and the U is non-empty open set in TQ, and the gamma is a non-constant closed geodesic with the metric FG, and the gamma 0, gamma prime 0 is in U. So this result works in arbitrary dimension, and also it can control the direction of gamma. However, it works only for C1 topology. And this my result works with the C infinity topology, but it works only for two dimension, and we can say nothing about the direction of gamma. So anyway, this is the really immediate application of the main result. And so finally, I want to explain the second and more interesting application. And this is a joint work with Asaoka in Kyoto University. So let S omega be a closed symplectic two manifold, and phi be a Hamiltonian diffeomorphism on S, and U be a non-empty open set in S, then there exists phi prime such that which is arbitrary close to phi in the C infinity topology, and P of phi prime. So this is the set of all periodic points is intersecting U. So this is the C infinity closing lemma for Hamiltonian diffeomorphisms on surfaces. And it implies the general density theorem. So for generic phi in Ham of S omega with the C infinity topology, P of phi is dense in S. And so this gives a partial answer to the following long-standing problem. So the problem is as follows. So let R be either positive integer or equal to infinity, and consider the space dr, which consists of every CR diffeomorphisms on S preserving omega and equipped with the CR topology. And now the question is that the set of phi in DR such that P phi is dense in S, so is the question is that, is this set residual in DR? In other words, is the CR general density theorem for area preserving map is correct or not? And so when R is equal to 1, it was affirmatively solved in the P. Robinson paper. And when R is larger than 1, the problem had been widely open. And as far as I know, the only result so far is the following result. So it works for every R. And the result is that for generic phi in DR, de so so the union of stable submanifolds of all the hyperbolic periodic points is dense in S. And so this result was due to for the two sphere, it was due to Franks and Lukov S. And for the higher genus case, it was proved by Shia, combined with recent paper by Koropeki, Lukov S, and Nassidi. On the other hand, when the surface is the twist sphere, this corollary positively solves the problem for every R. So indeed, when R is equal to infinity, the case R equal to infinity is immediate because every symplectic map on the two sphere is Hamiltonian. And to deduce the case when R is less than infinity, we use the fact that D infinity is dense in DR. That means that every CR symplectic map can be approximated by C infinity symplectic maps. And this is a result by Zender in 70s. And so now I'd like to give a sketch of this proof of the second application. So what I want to prove is this C infinity closed lemma for Hamiltonian diffeomorphisms. Yes. So yeah,
your statement is that also gives you a residual set.
Yeah, yes. Yeah, and so let me be finally I'd like to give a sketch of the proof of this second application. So let phi be a Hamiltonian map on S omega, and so take time dependent Hamiltonian on S such that the time one map is equal to phi. And so by the Arnold conjecture, there exists a fixed point of phi such that this corresponding Hamiltonian loop is contractible. And so we may assume that this Q is not in the closure of U, because we can replace U with a smaller open set. So we have a surface S, and this is fixed point Q, and this is a open set U. And we want to perturb this Hamiltonian map to have a periodic orbit intersecting this open set U. And so we first perturb phi on a neighborhood of Q to get a Hamiltonian map phi double prime, which is sufficient across to phi in the C infinity topology. And so this Q is again a fixed point of phi double prime. And we may assume that this is either hyperbolic or elliptic and Moser stable. And here, Moser stable means that the Barkov normal form has a nonlinear term. And we also assume that this phi double prime is real analytic near Q. And so we consider these two cases separately. And so in the hyperbolic case, we can show that this map phi double prime restricted on the neighborhood of Q is C infinity conjugate to a part of a certain global return map of a three-dimensional Reeb flow. And once we can prove this, we can just apply the closing lemma for three-dimensional Reeb flow. And to prove this claim, we have to understand the subtle behavior of this map on a neighborhood of this fixed point Q. And here the key fact is that in the hyperbolic case, the Barkov normal form converges. That is an old result due to Moser in 50s. And by using this result, we can use some explicit computation using Barkov normal form to construct such three-dimensional Reeb flow. And when Q is elliptic, we can apply the CAM theory. So there exists a CAM disk D. So this is a neighborhood of Q, diffeomorphic to D2, and invariant by phi double prime, and sufficiently close to Q so that which is disjoint from U. And then, so we can show that phi double prime restricted on a neighborhood of D is C infinity conjugate to a part of a certain global return map of a three-dimensional Reeb flow. And actually, this is much easier to prove from. The proof of this fact is much easier than this hyperbolic case. And then we can, again, apply our closing lemma for three-dimensional Reeb flow. So this is a sketch of the proof of this second application. And I'd like to stop here. So thank you for your attention.